Good evening, everyone, and welcome to Mint's webinar series, CMO Dialogues. Today, we will focus on the consumer durables and appliances industry, which is estimated at a massive over ₹80,000 crore. Surprisingly, even before the festival season started, the sector saw an uptick in sales of products like washing machines, dishwashers, and a range of smaller kitchen appliances as people stayed at home and worked from home. To discuss the state of the industry, the expectations from the festival season, shifts in consumer behavior, and the challenges ahead, we have a stellar panel today. On behalf of Mint, I welcome Mr. Tahir Hakim, Head Brand and Retail Marketing at LG Electronics India, Mr. Shirish Agarwal, Head of Marketing and Brand, Panasonic India, Mr. Deba Ghoshal, Vice President, Marketing and Key Accounts at Voltas, Mr. Ritesh Ghoshal, Chief Marketing Officer, Chroma Infinity Retail Limited, and Mr. Amit Tiwari, Vice President, Marketing at Havells India. My colleague Sunira will be my co-host at this panel discussion today. So to set the ball rolling, I have the first question for Mr. Ritesh Ghoshal, since he is at the front end of the sales through Chroma. So what we'd like to understand from you is that, would you say that the demand for electronics and home appliances changed once the unlock began?
Well, actually, even while the world was in lockdown, the demand for a lot of products, you know, started going up, starting with laptops. You know, lockdown also meant, you know, you started working from home, children started going to school from home. And therefore, the need to stay connected, need to be online, started, you know, filling the demand for better laptops and better smartphones and tablets. This was also, you know, the peak of summer. So people wanted ACs. People, you know, maybe you had only one bedroom AC, and now suddenly there were two people in the house, one worked in the living room, the other went to school in the bedroom. You wanted a second AC. So even before lockdown was removed or removed in stages, there was a pent-up demand. As the, you know, the country has progressed into more and more relaxed scenario, people have realized a lot of things were missing in their homes, and therefore, you know, that has led to queues outside of stores. There's been a run on dishwashers, home appliances, vacuum cleaners, a lot of things, you know, people were missing in their homes. And it's just the nesting instinct coming to the fore. You want to make your home as comfortable as possible because you're spending so much time at home.
Okay, so you're saying that the demand started picking up even before the government started easing the lockdown.
Oh, yes. Okay. The day the stores opened, there were queues outside.
Oh, okay. All right. And these queues were for which kind of products? Other than laptops, what else were people buying?
Home appliances, convenience products like dishwashers, fully automatic washing machines, vacuum cleaners, steam mops, things that go into the kitchen, starting from microwaves to OTG ovens to, you know, even simple things like an induction cooker. There was a qualitative shift in demand as people started, you know, requiring products which earlier were not that, not that hot in terms of movement of the jobs.
So, Mr. Agarwal, at Panasonic, how would you report sales once the lockdown was eased?
Okay, so at Panasonic, I can say we have seen some early signs of recovery in sales. So if I have to give you a figure, in July, we witnessed 17% growth if I compare it with the same period last year. And in August, since the festive season started with Onam in Kerala, we have already witnessed 18% growth, again, if I compare it with the same period last year. So for us, I think the signs are positive. I think the consumer sentiments are improving. This is more to do with the fact that, you know, during the lockdown phase, all of us were confined to our homes. And with almost limited or no domestic help, you know, the demand for products which can actually help users multitask, can ease their life, can keep them entertained, and the most important, can take care of their hygiene and safety issues have gone up. So we have seen tractions for big size televisions. So now the 55 inches is the new 40 inches, actually, if you look at that way. We have seen consumers walking and asking for refrigerators in the range of 550 liters and above. Similar is the case with washing machines. The demand for the fully automatic washing machines have gone up. Microwaves, there is a huge spike in the sales, kitchen appliances like mixer grinders and all that. So overall, I can say that there has been a positive sentiment that is going around, and we are, extremely optimistic that this festive season probably will help us in recover, whatever loss that we have witnessed during the lockdown phase.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mr. Tiwari, for you, which categories did well at Havells?
See, if you actually see the entire pent-up demand which started after the lockdown, I think every category has shown some or the other different trends. And majority of the trends have been across the categories to look for. You can't specify an individual category because if you see the wide variety of categories in which we operate today, right from the pre-preparation of home to the actual running of the home, every category has seen a huge demand. And that is also to do because most of the seasonal products, which are primarily in the month of April, May, and June, which are to do with the season, had actually given a huge uplift in terms of the overall consumer requirement in that particular season.
Okay. So with summer, during the summer months, the lockdown was on. So at Voltas, Mr. Kushal, I mean, did you see any uptick in the AC category or, the other appliances which Voltas is now with Voltas Beko? Sorry.
Deva, your mic is
mute. Sorry. COVID struck us, right in the beginning of summers in middle of March. And that's when the industry was just shaping up to prime up supplies to the channel partners, right? So April and May contribute almost 50% to the overall industry. So that's a big hit for the industry. But fortunately for us, end of May, when things started opening up, there was a huge pent-up demand. And June, July, we saw the summer getting extended, especially in North India and Central India. So that was a huge benefit for the category of cooling products. And we benefited a lot. As a leader in the industry, we had the reach and we had the brand equity, so we could leverage that opportunity. And June and July, we saw very healthy growth in the cooling products business. So I think whatever loss the industry had in April and part of May was partly compensated in the month of June and July. And we took a massive jump in terms of market share also in the month of June and July. So we lead the category. So our lead over nearest competitors went up significantly. So what we observed was that during this period, consumers really think about a particular brand, particular model, and they go and shop because they don't want to spend too much time on the shop floor. So brands which have got a significant share of mind in a particular category gained because people did their search online and they went to the offline store and bought a particular model. So all the brands which have got a fair share of mind benefited, especially in the cooling product business. Luckily, you have a second summer now coming in. So it's already there in many parts of the country. So the cooling product business has not gone down this year. It continues to rock, I would say. So we look forward to this momentum right through the festive season. On the other side, we also launched new product categories last year, which are doing significantly well. Our Voltas Beko range of appliances, home appliances have seen a good traction. We've seen the refrigerators, washing machines doing well. Need-based products like dishwashers also gaining good traction. But one thing we observed was that discretionary spends were lower. Need-based pent-up demand was much more higher for home appliances. Home is where the action is. So we're all sitting at home. We're running our air conditioner. We're running our appliances throughout the day. So there's a lot of replacement demand, a lot of pent-up demand, which we are observing, and that's going to stay. So mm-hmm. I think it's a positive momentum, which we are witnessing right now.
Sorry. Mr. Hakim, at LG, did you see increase in sales, say, a washing machine and or other of your products? And would you say that there is a shift in consumer behavior as well?
Yeah, it was a significant, as everybody mentioned, it was a significant growth in the entire appliances as well as the consumer electronics. It's basically the buying and the usage pattern which has changed in last few months. which has, you know, which has supported for this increase in the growth. And there are very significant changes what we can see now, that screen sizes becomes bigger, people preferring to buy a larger size refrigerators. Dishwashers and microwave as a product was not very much popular among the Indian households in the past. And we have seen a significant increase in the demand for these products, which somehow, you know, have created the market for these products, and it will be there for a longer term now, because you can find a lot of, you know, the Indian males and females becoming the chefs in this pandemic time, trying different recipes at their homes. So these things will be continued going forward.
Mm-hmm. So do you see that, you know, the penetration of some of these new categories growing really? I mean, say something like a dishwasher, which
yeah, yeah. Microwave with almost like a 1% penetration level in the country will be looking for a bigger numbers, because the way microwave usage, actually, it's not about the penetration only, it's about the usage pattern. All these, like, majority of the people used to use microwave for just for reheating purposes. But now it has replaced, and people, like, we have a lot of our health wave experts giving the cooking sessions, how to prepare different recipes. So it has inculcated a new behavior among the consumers, how for the product usage as such. And dishwasher, yes, of course, it has come up as a very highly demanded product of lately. And there was always a constraint in last 3 months in terms to meet the consumer's demand in the marketplace.
So these categories
are getting established in India, looking forward for these two categories especially.
Okay. So today, how many, there weren't too many dishwasher brands in India earlier. So do we see more companies entering the space?
Yeah, I mean, at least all the Indian brands or the all the international brands which are operating in India will be trying to add up this product in their portfolio going forward.
Mm-hmm. All right. Okay. Mr. Ghoshal at Voltas, now that, you know, the unlock is in place and the festival season is already started, so what are your expectations really from the festival season specifically?
I think this season you'll see a reasonably good demand coming up, because as I mentioned earlier, you have a pent-up demand and also you have a need-based category demand. So I don't see a dip in demand as such. But yes, we have to be conscious about the fact that discretionary spends would be little lesser and need-based spend would be much more. So we need to control our excitement in such a way that we need to, you know, channelize the energies towards products which are more need-based. You know, home appliances is something which will surely show some traction, because home is where the action is, as I said. And compared to last year's festival period, which was not so high in terms of volume offtake because of other reasons, this year we will see, I think, equal amount of traction vis-a-vis last year. So I think we need to be careful about what categories we should be bullish about and focus on those categories instead of running energies across the spectrum and running it too flat. So if you're conscious about what categories will do well, and we can forecast the supply chain well, and we can get the model mix right, and of course, we help the consumer in terms of barriers to adoption with good finance offers, good exchange offers, good cashback offers, good extended warranties, that would help, because consumer is still little cautious about how much he's indulging in. So as marketeers and as brands, we need to support the consumer and make the journey much more easier.
All right. Mr. Agarwal at Panasonic, would you hazard a guess if the sales this year will match last year's festival season sale? I think you're on mute.
Sorry. Okay, I think I would say we are highly optimistic looking at the trends that are coming from July and August, wherein we have seen growth over last year. I think the overall industry is gonna see a spike in terms of sales. So we are highly optimistic. And like one of my fellow panelists also mentioned, I think we'll see a lot of brands will be very aggressive as far as their festive offerings are concerned. You know, you'll see a lot of festive schemes, offers being rolled out by brands. But what is more important is that how well you package it so that you stand out of the clutter. I think that's even more critical for brands to, you know, so consumer register and take a note of what you have to offer. So, yeah, we are optimistic, I would say. And I think we will overachieve last year's number, actually.
All right. Mr. Ghoshal at Croma, one, how many of your stores are now open? Are they all, operational? And what are your expectations from the festival season specifically?
So most of our stores are open. Of our 170 operational stores, I think 160 plus are now operational. In terms of what our expectations are, see, we saw very strong growth in August. Okay, we in the month of August, our business grew over 20% versus last year. Right after that, beginning of September were the 2 weeks of Shraddh, and which is usually like a graveyard for our business. In the Shraddh, if I compare like for like with last year, our growth has been in excess of 25%.
So, in excess of 25%.
Okay. So what that means is there is a strong momentum in the market. And I think Deva was pointing out, people are spending in a circumspect manner. Actually, in our category, it's working to our advantage. I would think versus, the festive demand where there's a lot of apparel, a lot of home improvement. Then our category also comes in, or automobiles also come in. I think given the way life has changed for a lot of us, there is a higher likelihood of furniture furnishing or electronics being, seeing a good festive this year versus a maybe apparel or, some other items. And I think we are already seeing the green shoots of that. I would actually think, people will continue to put money into their homes, into making their homes more comfortable for themselves.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Mr. Tiwari, at Havells, which products are you, because I know you have a range of products, like you said earlier also, which products are you really banking on for this particular season?
See, I would take it in a different sense. And I think most of my fellow panelists, we are from the same industry, only talked about industry products and all. But one thing which we are actually missing from the entire discussion, which is you also need to see the consumer piece, how they're actually entire evolving and how does the consumer decision journey is changing. The products, irrespective what products come and all, I think that's a very secondary part of it today. But the bigger thing is what is actually consumer are actually trying to build it. So irrespective whether you go for any XYZ product or durables or whether it is furniture, the bigger thing is what is an affordability for a consumer and what is an actually authenticity for a consumer and what action you are trying to build. All these three A's will actually drive the entire particular consumer journey today. Every category, and I think Shirish boldly mentioned in terms of the numbers another particular panelist is talking about, I think it would be a surprise and would be a very, very different learning for every particular marketer, not only from the standpoint of sales, but also in terms of consumer behavior that it actually moves from. Also in terms of the pattern on which you're actually looking for. So previously, it was always a myth that volumetric products are not sold online today. After the post-COVID, everything has shattered and every particular myth has actually moved from it. So if you ask me, because right from an electrical to the consumer durable to consumer electronics, every category that I think, again, the answer would largely remain the same. Most of the category will see a big, big, big spike. And that is how it looks in the festival right now.
But when you're saying, looking at the consumer journey and how he makes the decision, will it be based on affordability or...
It has to be affordability, authenticity, and what actions you can actually drive. Because today, nobody is trying to go and filter in terms of what I really need to look for. And I think the dimensions of entire consumer acceptance of what they need to be have a reality is actually changing in a big way.
Mm-hmm. Sunira, I think you have some questions for the panelists.
I just want to understand, of course, how will the marketing spends this festive season differ from, let's say, last year? So at LG, for instance, Mr. Hakim, could you tell us how are you planning this particular festive season? Will your ad spend go up substantially? What channels are you advertising across?
This year, consumer demands, keeping in mind the whole scenario, it will be more of the integrated approach, has to be taken by all the brands rather. Because consumers will not be spending much time at the outlets. It will be given all the situation, even if it is getting normalized over a period of time. So consumers will be largely prepared when they come to buy the product. So it will be like more or less, they need to have the full acquaintance about the brand and the product as well as the features. So off lately for last 3-4 months, we are going very heavy on digital media for spreading the awareness to keep, a lot of awareness videos as well as the features and all that things. So digital will be one of the key marketing engine what we'll be utilizing. Of course, television will be also there. It will be like more like an integrated approach where a digital TV campaign as well as print will be part of it. And obviously, the spends will be higher than the previous years because we have no few more categories to promote this year as well.
Right. And could you give us a sense of how much more the spend would be? Is there a number to it in terms of percentage?
We are targeting almost a 30% growth in the festive season. So marketing spends will be in line with the same.
Right. Right. Mr. Agarwal at Panasonic, what are your plans? Are you also in line with what Mr. Hakim is saying? Will your ad spends also go up?
I would not say that ad spends will go up, but I think it's more gone a bit towards the performance marketing. You are more answerable these days on where you're spending and what ROI you are driving out of it. But one thing I can assure you that marketing mix is going to change for most of the brands across industry vertical. Digital is going to take the lead. Now, in general, people have this perception that, all industry verticals are spending heavily on television and print. But you will be surprised. There was a research done by Exchange for Media and Dentsu Aegis Network this year in January. Okay, it talked about if you look at the overall advertising industry, okay, and you split the investments basis touch points. Touch point means television, print, radio, digital, and all. When you look at overall industry, television takes the maximum share by almost 34%, and followed by print, which is 29%. Then it was digital, which is 20%. And then subsequently, you had outdoor, radio, and cinema. But moment you look at industry vertical wise and consumer durable industry, this data point changes completely. Now, keep this in mind that this research came out in January. Basis that research, consumer durable industry spends maximum digital. 38% of the investments are going in digital as a platform, followed by television, which is 30%. Print is only 14%. Why I'm emphasizing on January? Reason being, this data point is again going to change drastically post-COVID. Digital is going to get even higher share. So digital is the most important touch point when it comes to consumer durable industry. And why? Reason being, longer the purchase cycle, longer the consumer decision journey, higher the importance of a digital as a platform, because that's where consumers are searching, that's where consumers are researching. So our investments are primarily going to be led by digital, and we are ensuring that we drive a lot of performance marketing so that we are able to justify to our business heads that whatever monies they are spending, they are getting maximum bang out of the buck. So that's what our approach is.
Right. Are you also considering IPL? I mean, that's a big event that's back after a lull. So is that something you're advertising on, Hotstar?
No. So we are not present on IPL, neither on television or on Hotstar, but we are exploring other platforms. So we are extensively promoting it on social media platforms. We are doing heavy investments on influencer marketing because driving advocacy is extremely important at this time. And like earlier, it was mentioned, the penetration in the categories like microwave ovens, washing machines is still low. So the onus is on the brands to ensure that, they develop content which drives the application and the usage of the product. So we are investing a lot on creating those contents which actually details out how it using a particular product eases out your life. So our intent is toward those initiatives actually.
So Ritesh, what about Croma? You are already getting very strong footfalls in your stores. You need to, dedicate a big part of your marketing spends towards luring shoppers in, or you don't?
See, we actually are a channel. The brands create the demand, and we sort of, you know, fulfill the demand for the shopper. We have one port of call where the customers come in if they want to buy a product, you know, that Panasonic is promoting or LG is promoting. So we don't really, you know, spend that much money on advertising to create demand. We leave that to the brands. That said, the festive period is a natural time for a retail brand to, you know, build affinity with its patrons. And therefore, we do spend some money. You know, my thematic for the year actually happens during festive. So which we will be spending our money on. But it's not really about performance marketing. For me, performance marketing happens every day of the year because I need to drive footfalls into the stores. Festive is the time when I can actually build the brand. So I prefer to, you know, go thematic at this time of the year.
Right. But will there be more offers and promotions in stores, or will you go easy on that because you don't want to be crowds coming to the store?
No. So, like, I think Deva was pointing out, a lot of the research actually happens online. And post the pandemic, that has become even more reinforced as a habit. People don't want to come to the store, you know, rub shoulders with strangers just to do their research. So footfalls are actually much lower than last year. Conversions are more than twice of last year because the conversion, so to speak, in the customer's head is happening digitally. Once he's, you know, good and made up his mind is when he's coming to the store to do the final, you know, sense check and, you know, close the deal and make a payment kind of thing.
Mr. Tiwari, how are you looking at your marketing spend this particular festive season?
I think I can't agree more with what Shirish said. It's all about today. The need is all about performance. The brands has already been established. It's all about how do you do performance and how do you reach out today. And if you see the large canvas in which we are actually present, most of the brands today are present. It has to look into how do you look into non-metros as a big part of the entire piece. It is not about doing an umbrella bombing today. It's not about doing every category has its own specific category agendas and goals to look for. And I personally believe, and that's what I've been seeing from most of the researches today, is digital is no more a media, it's part of life today. And I think more concentration will actually go towards building your particular presence, building to the last mile in term. I think most focus and most approach will actually move towards digital. And I think in a one line, if you ask me, this festival is a digital festival. That's how I see from a consumer and from a marketing standpoint.
Right. But any, you know, percentage jump in how much you'll be dedicating to marketing spends this festive season?
I don't think so. I think that percentage can actually be very relevant today because we are actually comparing apple to oranges. I think that will not be the right place to look for. And that's not how I see and I perceive it.
Mr. Kusal, what about, you know, at Voltas, you know, your peak season, you're saying some of it is still tapering into September, October. So will you be pretty strong with your advertising as well?
Yes, why not? We don't only have cooling products, we also have home appliances now, which is growing at a much faster pace. So we are pretty bullish about, you know, tapping the consumer. But I'll just take a step back and I'll just point out a few things because you see the first 6 months of this financial year, April to September, what did we see? We didn't see any investments in marketing communication, right? But we saw sales happening. We saw distribution intact. We saw consumers coming back to us. So the learning is that people who invested in the brand in the past couple of years or a past decade or so have realized that investment is paying dividends today in this year, which is a challenging year for the entire industry. So, you know, brand building is important, not only for the particular year or particular month, it's important from a long-term perspective. And that's paying dividends to all these brands, which you're talking about today, and the industry, of course. So we have been having a fairly good share of expense and a share of voice across the industry. In our categories we operate in, and that has paid dividends in the first 6 months of the financial year. Moving forward, what we'll focus on is not only digital as such. Digital is a huge landscape, But I think we should be more tighter in our approach. And we will do a combination of search and activation. We have observed consumers really going in for search very aggressively now. So if we put our money on search and if we put our money on store activations, combine them together, what Ritesh was talking about will pay dividends in the festival season. So our investments in terms of effort and in terms of money would be around search and activations, of course, supported by a fair amount of thematic activities on electronic media, which is purely for the new categories we are entered in. So that's our play for the festival period. Yeah.
I just wanted to, of course, you know, since the panel has spoken about digital very strongly, I wanted to understand if this year will also be a big shift for the category towards online. We've, of course, seen mobile phones become one of the bigger categories, but what about large appliances? Mr. Hakim, how are you viewing the online sales channel this festive season particularly?
Online channel is rather, it's not in the establishing stage, but it has got established now. And thanks to whatever, like last 4 months, many of the people who were not very much accustomed to the online buying and all that things, they got accustomed for their routine buying in the last 4 months. So appliances, electronics, so online has become a destination point now. So it's one of the channel which has got established, and there will be customers who will prefer to do this. So as everybody is mentioning, research is happening online. So many people will be comfortable even not to have a physical look at the product by going to the outlets, but preferring to buy online as well. So the LG online, we also have started the LG online brand store operations, and the commercial players, they are in the market as well as the other channels. So it is going to be a high growth in the online sales as well in this festival season.
Right. Could you give a sense of how much of sales for the company could be coming from online, that's in the next 12 months or even this festive season?
This festival season, we are looking for at least almost like on a line of 40 to 50% increase over the previous year in terms of the online sales. Because online was like on the establishing stage in the earlier years, but I can say it is pretty established now.
Fair enough. And this is, of course, including the marketplaces and your own D2C channel that you have launched. All right. What about it, Panasonic, Mr. Agarwal? Are your thoughts similar? Are you also seeing a very big traction for at least large appliances also come online?
So I don't think there is any brand across this industries today who can say confidently that we can survive in today's market just buying present on in offline channel or vice versa. I think the touch points are becoming seamless. The onus is on the brand to ensure that they provide seamless experience to their consumers, whether it's an offline channel or an online channel. We have seen brands who were traditionally strong in offline channel now starting their online channel also. And likewise, brands who were strong, entered India market with only online, are expanding their offline base also. So I think both channels have their own role to play. We have to ensure that, whether a consumer walking into a store or checking an online website, the experience has to be similar. So we are also working in the same direction. I will resonate with what was said earlier. We are also witnessing a huge spike in the sales coming from online platform. And I would not say that it is eating into the offline channel sales. Actually, it's an additional sale that is coming. So overall, it's good for the industry. It's good for the consumers also because they have more options to choose from.
Right. But any numbers you could give us? I mean, will you see a significant shift to online this festive season, or it'll be more or it'll be slower for you?
No. So like I said, it's not that the offline sales are going to eat up the online, the online sales are going to eat up the offline sales, actually. It's the incremental sales that are coming. So what this pandemic or this lockdown has done for us is the people who are not, well equipped or well versed with using online platforms, have also got well versed with such platforms. So just to give you an example, my parents, who have never ordered anything from, a platform like Big Basket, my mom had to download that app and now she's ordering online also. So yes, we are witnessing growth. And I think if I compare it with last year, our online sales contribution must have gone up in the range of 40 to 50% for us also.
Right. Interesting. Mr. Ritesh, coming to you, you're of course the, you know, you represent brick and mortar. Of course, you have an online presence and your stores have been full. So what is your sense of this? We'd like to hear that.
So, number one, there is no additional demand. Let me be very clear. What goes online is going at the expense of offline and vice versa. I believe our category continues to be one. See, so when the lockdown started, we also started a lot of like, you know, book an appointment online to come to the store. Very large.
I think he's having a problem.
Yeah, should be late or should be...
Maybe Mr. Ghoshal can take up the rest of the question online.
Yeah, I think...
Yeah, probably he's got it.
I think what Ritesh was trying to say, if I may comment on his behalf, was the fact that, you know, there is no incremental sales which will happen through online. It will be a replacement of a particular channel through online. Consumer is still the same. And I don't think there are any watertight compartments anymore that online is X and offline is Y. So I think whatever we do from a marketing mix perspective, we need to be conscious about the fact that both the channels are important. And how we play in these channels is a different ballgame, whether we differentiate models for different channels or we have a different pricing strategy for different channels. That's a different strategy altogether, which each brand will deploy in the market. But online will not come at the cost of offline. Ritesh is back. I'll hand it over to Ritesh.
Yeah. Thanks for batting. Yeah. So what I was saying is, see, is the same customer. Okay. What continues to happen in a category is the final, you know, that one look confirmation continues to be extremely important. So if it's a phone, you want to feel it in your hand and, you know, see how it feels in your hand. If it's a laptop, you want to see the weight of it, you know, the touch of the keys and so on and so forth. If it's a refrigerator, you know, you want to open the door, shut it a couple of times, see whether your, you know, milk donga will fit in or whatever it is. That happens. When lockdown started, we started a lot of, you know, things like, you know, buy over a phone call, book an appointment at the store. We are in the process of creating a video calling service. So there are a lot of things which we are trying to do to both manage the footfall as well as promote sales online. Of course, you can continue to buy on Croma.com, same on as any other marketplace. We have seen our sales go up from being less than 2-2.5% of our total sales. Today, online sales are around 12%. So that is the extent of shift that has happened. So it's like a 5-5.5x movement. That said, the stores are, the moment, you know, the lockdown has sort of got relaxed, people are back in the stores. We have experienced, you know, we have had social complaints on social about, you know, people not maintaining social distancing outside the stores. Mm-hmm. So it's not as if the time for brick and mortar is over. I think tactile is a very important role to play in apparel, in consumer durables, you know, anything which is a big ticket item. And I think that will continue. But yes, you know, you can't ignore online. And what the pandemic has done is, you know, like you know, the other panelist also pointed out, people who have never been online have learned how to navigate that world and, you know, do commerce in that world. It's not going
right.
to go away.
Right. And just to check, so this shift to almost 12% happened in what, the last 1 year, you'd say?
Is that No. Between March and now.
Oh, in the last 6 months.
Yes.
That's just Croma dot in and not, of course. Interesting. Mr. Tiwari, what about at Havells? Is your thought process also similar to what other panelists are saying in terms of sales and the way it's jumped?
So I think it will not be different because everybody operates in the same category and everybody has the same channel. I think one similarity which I find from what Ritesh is talking about in terms of definitely stores play a different role, and definitely we are also a part of this role, and stores give you a different feel to a consumer, whether it is large appliances, even if you have decorative lighting, anything that a person really want to feel, see, touch, and look for. Little different in terms of approach what Ritesh and Deva was talking about. There are a lot of demand which is actually coming from towns which a penetration is actually moving. If you see the larger picture 5 years back, the way electrification has happened across the India, there are a lot of demand which are also coming from urban, semi-urban, and rural markets to look for. So only depending upon that, only the demand is only replacing, or it is just either or between online and offline. I think that's not the case with us or most of the people in the category to look for. There is quite a good demand which is coming because of better infrastructure in the markets which have not been there before. So that's the shift that is happening across the spectrum.
And Deva, just to check with you, how does a customer respond online for your categories, for instance? Air conditioners, do still people end up buying those, placing orders online? I mean, that would be a common practice.
Okay, so I'll just give a background to this online discussion which you're having in terms of sales. You see, online sales is a function of how searched you are online. If you're a highest search brand in the category, you will drive online sales. If you're not searched, you will not drive online sales. And you need to collaborate with your online players. We have the largest market share online also in many of the categories we operate in, because we are searched online. We invest a lot on search, and we are also searched as a brand in that category. So all the online players, all the aggregators, all the marketplace players, you know, will like to collaborate with brands which are highly searched. So before getting into the online sales aspiration to succeed, you need to be sure that you are searched online, and you need to be sure that you are the highest searched brand online in a particular category. If you're not, then you may not be able to succeed in sales. Secondly, for new categories we are getting into, and that also is a function of how to drive novelty around that category vis-a-vis our brand. And there we are playing a different role from an online perspective in terms of features, in terms of aspects of the products, in terms of differentiating ourselves from a thematic perspective. So online is definitely important. Our air conditioner category, our air cooler category has seen a lot of online traction. Our commercial ref category, which are freezers and stuff, has seen online from a B2B perspective. People are searching freezers and chest coolers from a B2B and a B2B-C perspective. Then our new range of Voltas Beko products, which are new in the industry, are being searched from a feature perspective. So it's very critical that what are the keywords you are investing in and what are the keywords you are strategizing for to gain traction online. And also the fact that you need to aspire to be an online player if you are a highly searched brand.
So will this be an offline or an online Diwali for you?
Definitely a combination of both. I will stick to that.
Okay. What do you
think? Okay. Actually, I'll just take off from where Mr. Tiwari, mentioned about the smaller towns and cities. Most FMCG companies have been saying that the smaller towns have been more resilient at this point of time. And I've also traveled and observed that there's far less fear, of COVID. So probably they may have performed better. But how does that translate into sales? Mr. Agarwal can start, because I think Panasonic launched something called the Bharat marketing vertical. If you could explain, throw some light on that.
So actually we have identified some rural and semi-urban markets. And like we have already discussed earlier, the penetration, for most of the consumer durable appliances, barring television, where we still have 65% penetration. But if you look at other categories like refrigerator with 13%, air conditioners has less than 5% penetration, microwave less than 1%. So there is a lot of, scope as far as the rural market and semi-urban markets are concerned. And we have already started seeing that, the first time buyers are coming from, rural and semi-urban markets. So yes, we have launched this initiative. We are expanding our distribution network. We are, aggressive in terms of, ensuring that we drive marketing initiatives. So we have recently launched a van project, which will cover the entire rural and semi-urban market of India, wherein we give the first-hand experience to consumers so that they get the touch and feel of the product also, which helps them in making an informed decision. So we are going aggressive, and hopefully we'll see that next year when we speak, probably we'll have better number as far as the other category penetration is concerned.
Yeah, sure. Mr. Ghoshal, is Voltas a very metro-centric brand, or you know, you have customers in smaller towns? And if these smaller towns, will these be tier 2, tier 3, or you know, the rural markets? What exactly is your constituency?
We have been there in India for the past 6 decades. So there is no reason why we should not be in tier 4 cities also. We are there across the spectrum. And in fact, our market shares across categories are across all tier towns. Tier 1 is how we define as 1 million plus. And tier 1 plus is 5 million plus. That's, of course, a big market for durables. Then tier 2 is 500,000 to 1 million, where we are strong. Tier 3 is 1 lakh to 5 lakhs, equally strong there. And tier 4 is shaping up now in terms of electronics, because electrification is happening in rural markets. And people are getting you know, power supplies which are of healthy nature. So power connections were a deterrent earlier. Now they are that's improving as we speak. So we see a lot of traction in tier 4 towns also, between 50k and 1 lakh population. We have a very good distribution reach across the country. We have the highest distribution reach for many categories we operate in. Our weighted distribution is about 70% in the country today. So that leads to a lot of healthy footprint across tier 2, 3, 4 towns, which we leverage. So we'll be there across all tiers as a brand.
Okay, thank you. Mr. Tiwari, you also mentioned about rural electrification. So basically, you know, with this, what kind of products are in demand in the smaller towns and even, you know, rural areas? Is it just the basic, you know, the washing machines, maybe semi-automatic, or, you know, more evolved products?
So I think it would be really surprised, and we did a lot of research in terms of finding out what exactly getting into these markets and what exactly would be the demand. And it is very contrary to what we said in Delhi and in Bombay and decide how does the rural work. Their aspiration, the amount of money that they have the best product today. So what you find it in a South Delhi or a South Bombay, they have the products in that particular semi-urban in the rural markets. And it is not about only about choice of any particular brand or the category. The awareness level about categories are very, very high in those markets. And to the surprise, even to a refrigerator, which will make people call it a very, very high in terms of a double door or a frost free, which may be high in terms of a amount to shell it out. Still, that has been an aspiration to look for. Many, many aesthetically designed products, because I had done massive and extensive traveling to these markets and did a lot of research. And I was quite amazed to see that the amount of aesthetically designed products and very, very costly from a cost perspective had been looked for. So I think it's not to do with the price anymore. And it is not about in terms of doing it only to look that what suits to it. Affordability is definitely there, and obviously the brand choice and the brand consciousness is much, much higher today.
All right. Thank you so much. Basically, before I hand over to Sunira, I have one question for LG, Panasonic and Croma. You know, you mentioned right in the beginning about large screen televisions selling more. So one, is this change during this particular period of the last 6 months? If so, what are the reasons? And today, what percentage do large TV sales constitute of the total TV sales? So maybe Mr. Hakim can start.
Television is a, you know, continuous evolving industry. It's one of the product category where we have seen every year there is some changes happening. Right from the projection, the round TV, then the flat, then the LCD, LED, now the Ultra HD, now the OLEDs. And now we have the paper thin OLEDs and the rollable OLEDs for LG as such. So that is, and the way the industry has evolved, people also realize, because television is one of the product category at the homes, you know, which people actually uses it. So everybody likes to have a bigger screen size. And with the it becomes more affordable now in terms of the screen size, in terms of the pricing. It's continuously on the rise. So all the 40 inches plus category, and rather now we are focusing on the 55 and the and above OLEDs. We have the Neo Gallery series and all that things, including the 88 inches. So these are the products which will be banking on for this Diwali, along with our OLED and the Nano Cell. And as far as demand is concerned, it is like, even during the immediately after the pandemic situation, what we have seen is an increase in the 40 inches plus category demand as compared to the smaller sizes. That means people might have realized that for even for a kid's education or for their own entertainment, for the family, it might be a time to change over their existing television and to opt for a bigger one. So that we have seen a very natural way of shift happening in the television industry in terms of the panel size.
Mr. Ghoshal, at Chroma, you know, what are the, which television sets are selling? And is it because of, you know, the Netflix and Amazons or, and also is there a second TV being also bought? Because in India, the percentage of, you know, second TV homes is quite low.
Yeah, so there are, you know, like the other panelists just pointed out, the big driver is actually price point. There is a customer who's got 25,000 rupees in his pocket. There's one with 50,000 and so on and so forth. What a 55-inch TV costs today is what a 40-inch would have cost a couple of years ago. Starting prices, of course. If you're talking about OLEDs, etc., that's a totally different ballgame. So that's one thing. In the lockdown, what has happened is, with nothing better to do, the demand for content has really shot up. Also because of work from home, etc., the connectivity with, broadband, etc., has shot up. What that means is the demand for smart TVs has really gone up. Also, like you pointed out, you know, now there are, there is a demand for more than one TV because, you know, it's a clash of the worlds inside the house. You know, there might be an older parent who wants to watch something on Tata Sky versus the kid wants to watch something on Netflix, and you just need a second TV. The third aspect is, so when I replaced my 46 inch with a 50 inch, I actually ended up occupying the same.
The kind of difference, the size of the TV has made over the last few years.
Right. What about Panasonic?
Okay, so more or less, I think everything is already said, but let me just present some data points. So as per the latest statistics, you know, in India, we have got 248 million households. And if you look at the penetration, 65% penetration roughly comes to 175 million. And like you already said, we are still a single screen or single television household. Okay, if you take some leeway and say there are houses where you have two screens also, you know, roughly it will go up to only 180, 190 million max. Okay, now what has happened is that, you know, initially my screen time was limited since, you know, I was in office, I go back home, at max I watch 1 or 2 hours of, you know, content on Netflix on Amazon, and I'm okay viewing it on my mobile phone. Now since most of the people are confined to their homes, you know, the screen time has gone up. So that is the one reason why the demand for a second or a third television has gone up, because I wanted to have my own personal, you know, viewing device. So one is that. Second, I think TV is no more just an idiot box, what we used to call it earlier. Now it has become a smart device. So while I use it to consume, OTT content, but I also need it for my kids' education. You know, online classes are happening. People want best experience for their kids. So people are using televisions for classes also. Third, a lot of official work is also happening because it's like a big screen. So it gives you a lot of comfort. So I think the multiple factors are driving the demand for television, especially the big size television. So it's good for us overall industry.
All right. I think Surya has the last question for you. We are also running out of time now.
Yes, I'm going to basically open this question to the entire panel. A lot of you also face supply issues, disruptions because of localized lockdowns and because of course, higher demand. So what are the big challenges that still remain in the market? Mr. Ritesh, if you want to take this up first. at Croma? What are the challenges?
So in terms of localized lockdowns, etc., the incidence has really gone down, thankfully. The challenges now are really more in terms of supply chains from the brand themselves, largely in laptops and smartphones. But you know, the dishwashers, for instance, we have been not getting adequate supplies for a long time as well. So supplies from the brands are not as regular as they have been, and it's to do with the mismatch in demand and the seasonality of demand, which has really gone for a toss this year.
Right, right. Mr. Agarwal at Panasonic, are you sort of, is your inventory pipeline full, keeping in mind the festive season, or are there some issues there?
So when there was a lockdown, yes, there were issues logistically in terms of material movement from one location to another location. But since the time the country has started opening up, we have not faced any major issues in terms of material movement of supply chain. Since most of the products we manufacture in India, so we are well equipped. So we haven't faced any challenge till now, and hopefully we will be able to meet consumer demands in the festive season also.
And this mentioned, is the consumer wallet a challenge right now? People are of course cutting back on our discretionary. Is that something of a challenge right now? Will you keep a tab on that? Mr. Agarwal, the question is for you.
Sorry, can you repeat the question? Because
the consumer's ability to not be able to spend a lot is also a challenge right now.
I think consumers are opening up. They are willing to invest. Like I earlier said, the onus is on the brands to ensure that how we share the financial burden. Okay, there is a pent-up demand. It's up to us how we come up with good schemes, good offers, with lure consumers. And because eventually everyone wants ease of life, especially in tough times. We're spending more time at home. The demand is there. I need the product. So how well can I serve that particular need is something that we all need to take up.
Right. Mr. Tiwari, any challenges that you think that you are facing in the market currently?
I don't think so, any challenges, but coming so near to your point in terms of cautious spending is definitely that I think what we are also observing across. It is not about the way it used to be that people are waiting for a big billion day sale or something like that, and people are already ready for doing a spendthrift demand on that. Cautious and also what you can actually afford and what is authentic for you. And I think that is actually driving a lot of decisions today.
Right, fair enough. Mr. Hakim, what are your thoughts on that?
Our biggest challenge is, as of now, is to cater to the demand of the Indian consumers. And luckily, with two local factories and with 24/7 working as going on, we are trying to cater to the needs. India actually being a traditional festival, and what we have seen in last 2 weeks during the Onam time and even during the Ganesha festival in Maharashtra, Karnataka and Andhra, that tradition still matters in the country. So the buying related during the tradition also picks up. Maharashtra was one of the most suffered places, especially the Mumbai, Thane, Pune, for the almost last 5 months. But when the things get a little bit eased up after 15th of August, we have seen some good sellout happening at the outlets. Consumers at Croma and all these places where people are standing in the queue. Even the local cops have to come to manage. So that way, we are looking for Diwali to continue with the old tradition, and consumers will be buying the products and will be, it will be a festive period once again.
Right. Mr. Bhushal, any thoughts on any challenges you continue to face in the market?
Whatever we had initially in the lockdown period is all over now. I think those days are over, and I think India is much more streamlined in terms of logistics and efficiency in supply chain. But however, we need to keep in mind the fill-in ratios of some retail partners, because they would be very careful about what they are stocking up and what they need to stock up, and they may need to also cater to the consumer demand very fast. So the turnaround time in terms of fill-in ratios are very important in the festival period. But I think more importantly is also what's beyond the festival period. How do we keep the momentum alive? That's important because festival period is going to go after Diwali, right? So it's important for consumer durable industry to keep the demand on, because this industry is gonna be looked at from a consumer perspective continuously, because consumers are gonna be sitting at home and operating. So we need to keep the momentum alive beyond festivals, and that should be the focus point, as we move along beyond November.
Yeah, just very quickly, Mr. Ghoshal, you talked about momentum. So would discounts help?
I would say ease of purchase would help, because of the fact that consumers are not looking at discounts. They're looking at the barriers to the entry to a category. So if you, as I said earlier also, if you look at good consumer offers in terms of finance schemes, cashback offers, extended warranties, that would help the consumer to take a decision faster. Fence sitters will no more be sitting on the fence. They will come forward to take a decision. So it's very important for brands to ease the the entry to a category, or to ease the replacement of a product in the house. So yeah, that would be very critical. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
I would like to add on to this. What we have seen during the moment the pandemic opens up during the May, June, India, still a lot of consumer durable buying happens through the, the finances. And when the finances companies were not supporting, or they were little bit keeping the hands down, they were not entertaining the new consumers, we have seen a sharp dip. But off lately, for last 1.5 months, even the consumer finance companies are also opening up. That is a good positive sign to support for the consumers for their buying behavior.
Great. Great point. Thank you. Thank you so much. With that, we come to the end of today's discussion. And thank you for sharing valuable insights on the industry and making time to join Mint's webinar. Thanks for
thank all you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.